In this report, we are providing some answers to questions for the Tesla shareholder meeting of 2021, including questions about its 4,680 battery usage in its electric vehicles. Tesla has a list of questions that owners of Tesla stock are wanting answered. When Tesla has their annual shareholder meeting on October 7, 2021, many of these will likely be addressed, especially those that have the most votes and share percent. I'm going to answer the top 10 questions for you. Tesla will hold its shareholder meeting on October 7. Torque News Tesla reporter Jeremy Johnson went ahead and provided some answers to questions that have already been raised for the shareholder meeting. Let's see if Jeremy is right. Does Tesla plan to offer any dividends to its shareholders in next 2 years? The answer is very easy for this one. Tesla will not offer any dividends in the next 2 years. However, as they continue to become more and more profitable, I believe they will offer dividends to shareholders after 2025, once they have more money than they know what to do with. Answer: in short, the answer is no, Tesla won't offer dividends to shareholders in the next 2 years. But I believe they will sometime after 2025. Is there any guidance on when Cybertruck production will begin and at what rate the ramp-up will happen? The Tesla Cybertruck will require full self-driving, FSD, hardware 4.0, which will be made by Samsung. The only way for the Cybertruck to be released any earlier than the second half of next year is for the Cybertruck to be built with FSD hardware 3.0, which is what is used now. If Tesla decides to build the Cybertruck with FSD hardware 3.0, then I think they could release them in the first half of next year, but it wouldn't be until the second quarter. Tesla is focused on getting the Model Y released from Giga Austin, Texas first. I don't see Tesla releasing the Cybertruck earlier than the second half of 2022, and I don't see them building it with FSD hardware 3.0. They're going to start production with the new hardware. Answer: Tesla will start Cybertruck production in the second half of 2022, probably around August or September. The ramp will be similar to the Model S Plaid, but less, starting with an event and the first 25 deliveries. After that, ramping to 750 the first couple months, and then more and more after that until volume production. But this will take longer as it is a completely new vehicle and bugs and issues will need to be worked out. With Tesla stock price back into the $700-$800 range, and likely heading higher, would you consider another split to allow retail investors to continue adding shares at a decent, per share, price? I believe there could be a split in the works, but it won't likely happen until next year when Giga Berlin, Giga Austin, Texas are ramping production, and the 4,680 batteries are being used. When Elon Musk tweeted this tweet, he wasn't saying that Tesla stock price wasn't worth the price it was and that it should decline in price. He was saying that the price was too high to buy individual shares and that a stock split would help make the stock more accessible to regular investors, even though that's not what he said directly here, I think that's what he meant. Tesla did a 5-to-1 stock split a few months later, August 31, 2020. Answer: I think Tesla will say that they will consider a stock split if the price keeps increasing. If it starts going well over $1,000, I think we'll see a split announced and it could be sometime in August of 2022. Can Tesla provide quarterly update on energy business along with automotive reporting deliveries and production? I like this question a lot. Tesla does a good job reporting on its automotive business. It says how many models of cars were sold, what the margins were, and gives good guidance for the future. Tesla also gives a delivery report a few weeks ahead of earnings for each quarter. The energy business isn't as well established as the auto business, but I think sharing deliveries makes a lot of sense and shouldn't be too difficult. This is not much to ask for investors in Tesla. Answer: Tesla will take this question and consider it and will also say that it is a reasonable request. I can picture Elon Musk, or whoever is on the meeting, saying something like, "That seems reasonable and we'll take that into consideration." Are we going to see 4,680 batteries sell this year in Texas? If not, what part of production is holding up? This is a good question. We haven't had a lot of information on the status of the 4,680 battery cells except that they are progressing along. I'm not aware of any timeline that Tesla has given for their release. Toward the end of July 2021, Tesla said there is still some work to do. I think that means there's a lot of work to do and I don't expect to see the 4,680 battery cells released this year. I do believe they'll start to get introduced in the first half of next year, but it won't be all at once. They will need to be integrated properly into the production process. Tesla may also be getting 4,680 batteries from manufacturers in China. I personally want to hear details about this, but I think Tesla will say it's too early to report on that. Answer: Elon Musk, or whoever is on the meeting, will talk about how production is hard and prototypes are easy. The 4680 battery still needs some work and will probably be ready in the first half of next year. It will take even longer for China suppliers, probably second half of 2022 or Q1, 2023. Any updates on the timeframe of when the Cybertruck or the Roadster will be for sale? This question is sort of a duplicate to an earlier Cybertruck question. I think the answer will be very quick and simple for this. Answer: the Cybertruck will start being sold in the second half of 2022 and the Roadster will start being sold in the second half of 2023. When will Tesla accept Dogecoin as payment for vehicles? I think Tesla will accept Dogecoin eventually, but it will have to have shown some stability in price and usage. Answer: Tesla will start to accept Dogecoin once we've seen some price stabilization and are confident that the network can handle the transactions properly. Tesla will also need to make sure there is no regulation problems with Dogecoin. Is there any chance Tesla may implement a dividend payout in the future? This question was sort of asked earlier, but it mentioned the next 2 years. I like this question better because it doesn't constrain the timeline of the dividend. The answer is pretty simple here. Answer: right now Tesla has plenty of uses for its cash, which include new vehicles, new gigafactories, the Tesla energy business, Tesla bot, and more. But, if Tesla were to reach a point where it has more money than it knows what to do with, a dividend most certainly makes sense. I don't see this happening anytime soon, after 2025.
When will the Model S, X use the new 4680 battery cells and updated pack?
How soon can we see production coming out of Giga Texas, Giga Berlin? I don't think the Model S and Model X will use the new 4680 battery cells in 2021. It will probably be the second half of 2022 or Q1, 2023, per the answer to an earlier question about the 4680 cells. The priority will be the Model Y and Cybertruck, and maybe event the compact Model 2 before the Model S and Model X get the cells. It all depends on how quickly the quality control and production ramp for the 4680 cells happens. Answer: I don't see Tesla using the 4680 cells for the Model S and Model X until late 2022/early 2023. Other vehicles will take priority, like the Model Y from Giga Texas and Giga Berlin, along with the Cybertruck. Are we on track for FSD Beta 10.2 tomorrow night? Will this be the single stack update? What's the rollout plan going forward for new FSD beta testers? How long is it expected to take to open beta up to anyone with an 80% safety score or higher? This is a great question, or rather many great questions in one. Here's what I think Tesla will say. Answer: we are on track for FSD Beta 10.2. It will not be a single stack update. We'll wait until 11.0 for that. The rollout plan for new beta testers is 1,000 per week depending on safety score. We'll need to watch how it goes with each batch of users. I'm not sure opening up the beta to anyone with an 80% safety score or higher is the right way to do the rollout. We'll start with those with the highest safety scores first. Based on behavior, we'll determine if an 80% safety score means we can release to more people at once. Well, that's it. That's the top 10 questions for the Tesla shareholder meeting. I did my best to keep answers simple and concise. What do you think about these answers to the questions for Tesla's annual shareholder meeting for 2021? Am I close, or are there things I've missed? Also, in a recent development, Tesla delivered 241,300 electric vehicles during the third quarter of 2021, the company reported Saturday. The quarter's deliveries topped expectations. Analysts predicted that Tesla would deliver around 220,900 electric cars during this period, according to estimates compiled by Street Account as of September 30. The company produced 237,823 cars in the period ending September 30, 2021, Tesla said in its report. Of that, 228,882 were its Model 3 and Y vehicles, its more affordable mid-range offerings. The remainder produced amounted to 8,941 of its Model S and X vehicles. Last quarter, Tesla delivered 201,250 vehicles and produced 206,421 cars, even as production of its Model S and X vehicles fell below 2,500. Our delivery count should be viewed as slightly conservative, as we only count a car as delivered if it is transferred to the customer and all paperwork is correct. Final numbers could vary by up to 0.5% or more, the company said in a statement. Tesla does not break out delivery numbers by model, nor does it report sales or production numbers from China versus the US. Deliveries are the company's closest approximation of vehicle sales. Tesla put customers through repeated, unexpected delivery delays during the quarter. In their release on Saturday, the company acknowledged the delays, blaming them on global supply chain and logistics challenges, then thanked customers for their patience. The press release announcing the production and deliveries report was dated Austin, Texas. Tesla's website still lists its headquarters as being in Palo Alto, California, but Elon Musk moved to Texas last year and the company is building a new factory in the Austin area. Tesla is also planning to host its annual shareholder meeting at its plant, now under construction, near Austin on October 7. Musk previously threatened to move Tesla's headquarters out of California in the spring of 2020 when the state's COVID-related health orders required Tesla's Fremont factory to temporarily suspend operations for a few weeks. At the time, California Governor Gavin Newsom told CNBC he was not worried about Elon leaving anytime soon, and voiced support for Tesla. Elon Musk's electric vehicle maker now produces cars at its Shanghai plant and U.S. factory in Fremont, California, while continuing to produce batteries domestically with Panasonic at their sprawling facility outside of Reno, Nevada. During the period ending September 30, 2021, Tesla began to ship some lithium iron phosphate batteries from China to be used in Model 3 vehicles made for customers in the U.S. Tesla also temporarily suspended some operations at its vehicle assembly plant in Shanghai, where it makes cars for customers in China and Europe. The halts were attributed to a global semiconductor shortage, which has posed a challenge to Tesla all year, and plagued the entire auto industry. New battery electric models, notably Rivian's R1T and Lucid Motors' long-delayed luxury Lucid Air sedan, are now in production and selling to customers in the US, an indication that competition is heating up in key markets for Tesla. At the same time, interest in electric vehicles is rising too, even in the US, a laggard in adoption compared to China and Europe. According to a June 2021 survey from Pew Research, 39% of Americans say that the next time they purchase a vehicle, they are at least somewhat likely to seriously consider electric. About 7% of Americans said they have already purchased a pure battery electric or hybrid electric vehicle. That demand is only encouraged by rising fuel costs and environmental regulations. For example, in China, government programs make it far quicker and cheaper to get license plates for electric vehicles than internal combustion engine vehicles. The Chinese government has also offered subsidies, tax breaks, and invested in charging infrastructure to encourage EV production and adoption. Meanwhile, President Joe Biden set a voluntary target for half of all new vehicle sales in the U.S. to be electric models by 2030, including battery electrics, plug-in hybrids, and hydrogen fuel cell vehicles. The move is part of the Biden administration's pledge to reduce U.S. emissions by in half by 2030. Piper Sandler senior research analyst Alexander Potter, a bull with a $1,200 price target for shares of Tesla, wrote in a note on September 27. Tesla's share of the battery electric vehicle, BEV, market will almost certainly fall, because many peers haven't started selling BEVs yet. But we fully expect Tesla's share of the overall market to continue rising, and we stress that declining BEV market share should not be considered a bearish signal. After all, Tesla is competing against vehicles of all types, not just against other electric vehicles. Auto Forecast Solutions Vice President Sam Fiorani agreed. He said, Tesla has such a head start on the competition in the EV market that it is unlikely for anyone to pass them anytime soon. The cult of Tesla will keep buyers attached to the brand for years to come. Even Audi and Mercedes are finding it difficult to tap into the same type of aura. While their market share will decrease, Tesla will keep the leadership position for years to come without a major misstep from within the company. Also, friends, in a new interesting development Tesla several days ago, Tesla's CEO Elon Musk revealed in a tweet that Tesla batteries now have no cobalt at all in most of their cars and only tiny amounts in others. Musk said Tesla is going to zero cobalt soon, whereas phones and laptops primarily use cobalt in their batteries. Elon Musk's tweet came in response to a Twitter user who linked the electric car maker to child labor for cobalt in the Congo. The electric car manufacturer Tesla is considered a pioneer when it comes to e-mobility. Even if electric cars are considered an environmentally friendly alternative to conventional combustion engines, there are also materials in the batteries of the vehicles that are definitely considered problematic. Car manufacturers are repeatedly criticized for the use of cobalt in particular. As Tesla boss Elon Musk recently revealed via Twitter, Tesla is almost over with that. Cobalt is an important component of e-car batteries. Precarious mining conditions and child labor in the Congo call human rights organizations to the scene. Tesla boss declares that even now hardly any cobalt is used in Tesla batteries. How is it possible to do Tesla batteries without cobalt now? Musk's statement now invites speculation as to how exactly the electrical pioneer could have achieved this impressive achievement. According to the relevant industry portal TeslaMag, there are two possible explanations. On the one hand, this could mean that the use of LFP cells in the USA is now making more progress than previously assumed. The last official stand was that Model 3 buyers were offered to use the LFP batteries produced in China. According to TeslaMag, another possible explanation could be that the production capacities in China have now far surpassed those of the Tesla plant in Fremont, which must also mean that almost all Tesla Stromers produced in China now have LFP batteries. Whatever the battery status of the various Tesla models, it is no secret that Elon Musk would like to use more LFP than cobalt-containing batteries in the long term. The question is how long it will be before then.